Hello and welcome to Music at the Monastery. I'm Father Jim Gardner, one of the friars on the staff here at the Franciscan Monastery of the Holy Land in Washington, D.C. My special honor this afternoon, or at this time, to welcome Jordan Prescott from the Peabody Institute, a student at Peabody Institute in Baltimore, Maryland, for this recital. I know you will enjoy it. Thank you for joining us. God bless.
My first piece this afternoon is by an African-American composer, Adolphus Hailstork, and it's a rousing toccata on the Christmas or the Advent carol, O Come Emmanuel. Is by French female composer and organist Jeanne, Demessieux, who is a longtime organist of Church of the Holy Spirit in La Madeleine in Paris. You'll hear two pieces by her this evening. The first you'll hear now is a beautiful setting of Rorate, which is the second part of the typical Advent motet, Canite Tuba, or Blow Up the Trumpet in Zion, announcing the impending coming of Jesus Christ. This is Jeanne, Demessieux, Rorate.
Thank you.
Johann Sebastian Bach is probably a composer who needs no introduction. The piece I'm playing this evening is from his collection of Schubler chorales, which are all Advent chorales based on cantata movements that he wrote earlier in his career. This is a setting of Wachet Auf, or Sleeper's Wake for Night is Flying, and is the third movement of his cantata on the same title. This movement is for string obbligato and the tenor section of the chorus. For the strings, you'll hear that in the right hand on a bright registration of 8 and 2, and then you'll hear the tenors of the choir singing on the trumpets. This is Bach's Wachet Auf.
Thank you.
you've ever wanted to hear the traditional Christmas carol, O Come All Ye Faithful, played in inversion and against itself, you're in luck. The next piece on the program is by Charles Ives, an American composer who was not appreciated in his time, mostly because he did really, really crazy things, like putting the carol, O Come All Ye Faithful, in the melody and inversion and playing it against itself. Nonetheless, I think it's a really charming setting of this beloved carol, and so I hope you enjoy Charles Ives' O Come All Ye Faithful. Coming back now to our friend Jeanne Demessieux, this is a much larger piece by her, a prelude and fugue in C major. This piece was written for the final examination of the organist in the class at the Paris Conservatory, and is a real tour de force. The prelude has a sparkling registration in the right hand against lots of warm foundation stops in the left hand. And the fugue is really quite inventive and almost sort of a scherzo or joke type fugue. The subject, which you hear at the beginning, is twisted and turned in a number of ways, and one of the most sort of inventive ways is a double entry at the tritone, which will be when they are quite dissonant against each other, but it's really sort of an amusing little piece, and I hope you enjoy Jeanne Demessieux's Prelude and Fugue in C major. Thank you. Charles Marie Widor was the longtime organist of the Church of Saint-Sulpice in Paris. He wrote many symphonies, 10 to be exact, and this is a movement from his ninth symphony. I think most composers are pretty nervous to write a ninth symphony because if you take a model from Beethoven, it's probably the last thing that you'll ever do. So instead of calling it the ninth symphony, he calls it the Symphonie Gothique, and he wrote it for the dedication of the organ at Saint-Ouen and Rouen outside of Paris. This is the third movement of this symphony, and is one of the most gorgeous pieces in all of the French romantic organ music. So if you enjoy the Andante Sosteunto from Widor's Symphonie Gothique.
Thank you.
Jeanne Langlais is the last in a series of three famed organists at St. Clotilde Church, beginning with César Franck, and then Charles Tournemire, and then finally Jeanne Langlais, one of the most mystical composers of 20th century France, possibly second to Messiaen. Most of Langlais' organ music is based in scripture and biblical stories, and this piece, La Nativité, is no exception. It's a programmatic piece about the nativity of Jesus Christ. At the opening, he has subtitled it La Crèche, which is the manger, and you see almost sort of a pastoral scene with calm sounds in the hands and a reed solo in the pedal, perhaps similar to what someone might have played as a lullaby to the baby Jesus in the manger. The second section is the angels, and it will not be hard at all for you to imagine the angels flying around the church during this section. And following the angels, we have Les Bergers, or the shepherds. And this is a sort of a shepherd's pipe carol that would have been played as they were moving around. And actually this melody is a traditional carol from Brittany, the region in France where Langlais was born. After the shepherds, you have a brief little return to the angel idea, which I think is sort of the angel announcing to the shepherds that they have arrived, or the angel ascending over the nativity. And then the last section is entitled The Holy Family, which depicts the full scene of the shepherds and the angels and Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus in the manger. And that's with the really lush strings in the hands, with a 4-foot solo flute in the pedal, which just soars over the entire texture. The final thing you hear is, in my opinion, the star in the east rising, alluding to the wise men coming in 12 days after Christmas for the Epiphany. And so you'll hear the star rising from the bottom of the organ to the very top as the piece settles into its final chord. I hope you enjoy Jeanne Langlais' La Nativité from the Evangelical Poems.
Thank you.
Though we have yet to have any snow yet, I like to call this piece sort of the wintry slush. And this final piece in the program is Richard Purvis's Carol Rhapsody. It begins with the most sultry, slushy setting of Silent Night you're likely to ever hear. That's followed by a sort of scherzo in Hark the Herald Angels Sing, and followed lastly by a rousing toccata on O Come All Ye Faithful. Thanks so much for being with me this afternoon. I hope you enjoyed the program. It's been such a pleasure to be here at the monastery in this incredible space and playing this wonderful organ. So I hope you enjoy Richard Purvis's Carol Rhapsody.